It is my pleasure to welcome you all to Logan University. Please be seated. I am Dr. Alan Bonashinsky, your Master of Ceremonies for this evening's event. I am one of 20 outpatient physicians that you will be meeting near the end of your journey here. Your class represents the summer 2019 entering class into the College of Chiropractic. You have made a good choice. Today's ceremony will rival another great day in your chiropractic education to be held in August of 2022. That is your graduation. You are entering the profession at an exciting and evolving time. Your experience, excuse me, your experience here just like anything else in life will be what you put into it. There will be many highs and a few lows along the way. You will meet uncomfortable times, but try to navigate those situations with optimism. When times get uncomfortable, it merely signifies that a breakthrough is about to happen. Learn to be patient with yourself. Learn to lean on one another and to create a network or team to make you the strongest version of yourself. I would like to thank all those in attendance, including the live web stream, for their encouragement and support of these new students as they become part of the Logan family. Will the faculty and staff in attendance please stand? These individuals will be instrumental in your success. Many have helped you during your admissions process and will continue to guide you. They are the foundation of the university, and we thank them for all they do to support the students. They will shape you into the doctors you will become. Listen, ask, and absorb what they teach you. They are your best resource and mentors for life. Thank you to Logan's faculty and staff. The white coat you receive tonight signifies the beginning of your career as a chiropractic student. It is a rite of passage for first-year students and designed to instill the value of professionalism and compassionate patient care. The coat you will be presented with tonight is white in color, representing purity and cleanliness. As a student, your coat is hip length. When you graduate, you'll wear a full-length coat, indicating that your training has been completed. These doctor's coats are a symbol of our profession. It is a privilege to wear one. Please keep them clean, wash them often, and perhaps even iron them. It is now my pleasure to introduce Dr. Vincent DeBono, Logan University's Dean of College of Chiropractic. Dr. DeBono.
Well, thank you, Dr. Banachinsky, and welcome to our new incoming class. I'm going to start tonight with a short video from one of our patients at our Myrtle Hilliard Davis clinical site. She recently spoke at one of our seventh trimester clinic induction luncheons, and her story was so compelling that we started to show it to a lot of our incoming classes to frame a little bit of what you're about to get yourself into, because this program is tough, and sometimes you have to keep your eyes on the prize. And I think her name is Catherine. She was treated by Dr. Ross Maddox, and she definitely will help you keep your eyes on the prize. So if we could show her story.
I am the victim of a horrific car accident where a woman was texting and knocked my husband and I off of Interstate 55 going back north, coming from Aberdeen, Mississippi, from a wonderful family reunion. She hit us and knocked us over. We hit every rock and stubble, and we finally hit the bottom, and we hit a tree, and the car exploded. The airbags burn up right before our eyes. I looked over and I saw my husband's forehead on the steering wheel. I'm like, it looked bad. I was able to get that phone and call 911 right away. And cars had already started lining up to come and help. It's a wonderful thing how people come to help you. My foot had been severed completely off. They wanted to amputate the leg. I asked my higher power, which I call God. I said, God, please don't let them take my leg. They did as much as they could do to put me back together. I was broke up. I was broke all the way up. But as far as they could see from their noses, they put me back together. Dr. Ross started working with me. He said, looks like you have been really broken. I said, I am, and I don't know what much you can do because they just give me pills. They said, this is just keep you comfortable, give you the pain pills. And I mean, I can't stand these pain pills, but you take them, you go to sleep, I'm nodding out, and you don't even, it's a sad quality of life. Well, when they started with me at Myrtle Hilliard Davis, and they started working with me, first I tell him, I said, well, in the back of my head, it just hurts real bad. I said, and I can't hardly breathe. My sinuses are all messed up. I keep a headache. And let me tell you, the relief from pain, I couldn't believe these things were happening, and it wasn't the medicine, and it wasn't those medical doctors. I said, there's something to this. This is really a good thing, chiropractic medicine. They started straightening me up. Boy, I started looking a little better. I said, well, wait a minute. Maybe I can dress a little bit better. I started feeling a lot better about myself. I even found some makeup that I could put on. Dr. Mann, I told him, I said, listen, I like this. This makes me feel good. I don't use as many pills. Anything to get me off of those pills. I said, they hook you on those pills. They really do. And what you all are fixing to go out and face and do, I don't know if they were broke up like I was, but they put me back together. And chiropractic medicine has aligned my bones and been keeping me together since. I wouldn't miss an appointment for nothing in the world.
Now realize, Catherine isn't standing in front of us without the EMTs, the MDs, the surgeons who put her back together again. So this isn't a knock on any other profession. That's not what this is. But what it does show you is, what role do you play in that team? Again, she's not standing in front of us if they don't put her back together again. So thank God they were there and that service was available. And she wasn't an amputee, they salvaged her limb. While they put her back together again, it's the chiropractor who made her whole, who put the parts and made them act as one. Because think about what she went through. I mean, she had a devastating loss. Her husband lost her life. She almost lost her leg. She watched her husband die in front of her, plus some devastating musculoskeletal injuries that had a profound effect on her ability to move and her ability to function. Now, when she said, they hooked me on those pain medicines, again, that's not a knock on that profession. They do what they know to do, and they know to relieve pain. There's no doctor out there who goes maliciously out to get you hooked onto an opioid. That's not how that happens. It's with every good intention they're trying to help. They see you're suffering, and that's all they know. The unfortunate part that we now know is that opioids don't really work for back pain. They're not very effective on musculoskeletal pain, partially because a great deal of musculoskeletal pain has a lot to do with a psychosocial influence, which opioids tend to make worse. So why did Catherine respond so well to our care, our aftercare, versus everything else? Because we addressed that issue with her. We addressed the psychosocial issue. We talked about the pain, the loss of her husband, what her limb was going through, the decreased function. Will she be perfect again? No. Nor did we set that expectation for her. But we're going to make her as good as she can be. And once that idea flipped into her head, that she can be as good as she can be, she can function normally again. Maybe not like before the accident, but good enough where she's pain-free or as close to what she can tolerate every day without pills, she went and bought a new dress. So what's that tell you? I felt good about myself. You know, when you guys hit milestones, you tend to give yourself a little bit of a treat because you give yourself a break. So I think the important part to realize about that video, you will see this in your office every day of your life. Now, not everything's going to be just dramatic where you're rescuing you're helping a patient with a limb salvage that's coming out of a devastating auto accident. We just came back from a clinic abroad trip in Cuba, and one of our case studies, in fact, Sheldon Suckert, who was one of your guys today, was there. And he had pretty irretractable leg pain for 2 to 3 weeks. So they came in to see us. We were the only chiropractors in Cuba. There is no chiropractic in Cuba. And we did some simple extension, directional preference work, and his leg pain subsided. Well, afterwards, the man was so grateful. It was a simple maneuver. His leg pain went significantly down, and he felt like he had a solution to keep driving his cab every day. That's just as dramatic as what she just said. These simple little things, like you took my pain away, or I can keep working. And you see their whole face change. You'll get that every single day. You know, we always watch these medical shows, ER and whatever, House, that these dramatic life-saving surgeries that they come in and save this obscure disease process. But what they never show you is the devastating effects the patient has to go through to get back from that. That's the most important part of the care. There's an old saying in medicine, the operation was a success, but the patient died. Just because they're successful at saving a life, getting the life and vital signs restored, it's up to us to put the pieces and the whole person back together again. And that's truly the profession you're getting into. So that's why we always like to show this video, get you guys ready. It's a great profession, and I can't wait to get you started. So now I'm going to bring Dr. Banachinsky back up again, and he's going to introduce some of tonight's speakers.
Thank you, Dr. DeBono. The Logan community is pleased that you have chosen to complete your education here and want to provide you with the support that will assist you in being a successful student and later practitioner. To offer words of encouragement as you start this journey, I would like to ask Dr. Daniel Hahn, representing our faculty, to welcome you to Logan. Dr. Hahn.
Welcome. It's an honor to represent the faculty, and congratulations to all of you, the incoming class in our Doctor of Chiropractic program. I know today's been a very event-filled day, and tomorrow will likely be the same because you're going through orientation. So it's probably not very likely that you're going to remember most of the words I say today, and that's okay. I accept that. I acknowledge that. You're probably going to remember most of all, at least from this ceremony tonight, how you felt at certain moments. So I hope that my words will spark some self-reflection and that the feelings that you will experience here tonight will help motivate you now and on the and in the future, long after the sound of my voice has stopped ringing in your ears, so to speak. So, first off, I need to thank you, because if it was not for our students, both past, present, and future, this institution would not be here. The faculty would not have anywhere to do what we love to do, which is mentor and teach students, future doctors of chiropractic. So a thank you to you is deserved. But let's talk about a few other things. And like I mentioned, some feelings that you may be feeling. These questions you can answer in your mind, or if you feel inclined to verbalize your answer, go ahead. Do you feel alone at this point? You shouldn't, because there are many, many people both in this room, on this campus, and across this country and this world that are here for you. Your family and friends first and foremost, but here at Logan, there are many, many people that have your success as their number one priority. Your classmates will become a great support network. The classmates that you see seated next to you today, your fellow students in the Doctor of Chiropractic program, and those that have graduated from this institution. The Office of Student Affairs, the Department of Student Affairs, has as their primary goal the success of students. So you'll be working with great people, many of whom you met today and will work with tomorrow and throughout your time here, whose main goal is to see that you reach your goals. And most importantly, in my very biased opinion, the faculty are here for you. We are here to guide you on your journey. I use that term guide on purpose. You are not an inert lump of clay that just by being placed in a room here on campus, you'll be molded into a masterpiece by the hands of our master faculty. That's just not how the process works. Just because you signed up for classes and paid your tuition doesn't mean that you will become what you want to be. You have to take an active role in your learning. And additionally, as faculty, it is our responsibility not just to throw information at you or content at you like farmers feeding chickens on a farm. It doesn't work that way. It works very differently. So it is a relationship of shared responsibility that you share with us as faculty. We will expect a lot from you, there's no doubt about that, but we will also be here to support you in any way we can so that you achieve the goals that you have set for yourselves and that we expect you to achieve. We are your guides on this journey. We can show you the path. We can even shine a little bit of light down the path a ways, but we can't walk the path for you. You have to do that yourself. And there are no shortcuts here, so keep that in mind. Do you feel excited? I think you should. You're embarking on a journey of learning, and I'm going to throw this term out there now, lifelong learning. So the fact that you entered this course of study indicates that you are willing to learn for the next 10 trimesters so that you can become the doctor of chiropractic that you want to be. However, I'm also here to share some reality with you. Learning doesn't stop after you walk across this very stage here after you finish your 10 trimesters. You are engaging in a career that will demand that you become a lifelong learner. If that doesn't sound very appealing to you, then hopefully you can get to a point where that's going to be pretty darn exciting. And I'll give you a quick example. In research, we often formulate a question and then design a research study to test that question or that hypothesis. And in the process of trying to answer a question, many more questions bubble up to the surface. That is a nice little capsule of what your learning experience will be like here. You'll come with many, many questions, many holes to be filled in your knowledge base. And in the process of doing that, many more questions will arise. And eventually, you're going to acquire a pretty good base of knowledge that will serve you. But if you think that you're going to learn everything you need to know in 10 trimesters here, that's also going to leave you very disappointed if that is your understanding. Because we will give you the skills and the basic knowledge you need to be successful, and then your patients will become your best teachers as you move on from here. So lifelong learning is actually something to be excited about, to be cherished. And speaking for the faculty, we are so excited to be your guides on the first part of your lifelong learning journey. And my last little point, do you feel humbled? If you don't feel humbled today, you will. Obviously, you'll encounter stresses, hardships along your path of education, or just because this education is so rigorous and it requires your full attention and full devotion most of your waking hours, and sometimes it'll take away some of your waking hours as a result. But that's all part of the process, and that's not the humility I'm speaking of. The humility I'm speaking of, to echo Dr. DeBono's words, comes from this specific knowledge that someday other human beings on this planet, in their time of need, in their midst of pain, and perhaps even in their darkest hour, will seek you out. People that you haven't even met yet will be searching for help. They will be seeking help and will be bringing with them physical, mental, and emotional problems that you have never encountered before. In a few short years, it will be your utmost privilege and responsibility to help relieve the pain and suffering of other human beings. And you will have that unique opportunity to be trusted by other people and help them regain their health. That is probably the most humbling thing I can think of, is to have that wonderful opportunity, like you saw a great example in the video presentation. And everything we do as a faculty is to help prepare you for that moment. We're your guides to acquiring the knowledge and skills so that when that very special time comes, you'll be ready. So, in the next couple of months, years, when you're struggling for motivation, when you're struggling to manage your time well to help achieve the goals that you set for yourself this day and previously, think of your future patients. Let them be your motivation. When you finally do encounter them, they will think that you are the best out there. So that is what you need to become. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Hahn. Please help me welcome Dr. Andrew Duro, a 2012 alumnus of Logan College of Chiropractic.
Those are hard shoes to fill, Dr. Hahn. Well, I want to say, based on what he just said, it made me think of a couple things that I didn't already prepare. Humble, hungry, and nervous. That pretty much is the main theme of every day of my life when I started with you in your shoes till this morning, actually. So I want to say thank you for continuing to carry that torch of humble, hungry, and nervous. It's very normal, and it's actually exciting. So you should all be very, very proud of the hard work you're about to do and all the hard work you've done leading up to this point. It's not very common and not very normal that people put their time and their money on the line. And I really respect everything you guys have done up until this point and would love to help further that journey. But because I'm not very original and I had a lot of good mentors, I'm going to share some quotes with you guys and keep it short and sweet. You see, mentors do special things in life. They really don't teach you how to read a book. They teach you how to interpret what you just read, how to apply it in the real world. And if it weren't for the mentors, I wouldn't have been so lucky. I wasn't a straight-A student, but all I knew is that my mentors told me to work hard, persist, never give up. And one of the things one of my mentors taught me was something called the formula for success. And if you're like the future Logan students that you will become, you'll get very familiar with mnemonic devices, things that make memorization easy. So that's how I got by my board exams, endless amounts of mnemonics. So team equals success. So training plus ability plus experience plus maturity equals success. And mentors allow you to foster that much more quickly than if you do it on your own. You see, the utility of a mentor is to help guide you, to help you become professionally mature, emotionally mature, and personally mature, so you're able to take on the seriousness of patient care. So I hope you understand that finding a mentor might not be easy. All you have to do is go up and ask somebody. So have a little bit of luck and a little bit of pluck, and you'll find yourself a mentor pretty quickly. So remember, many hands make light work, and of course teamwork makes the dream work, and many, many practices, including the one I'm developing, is integrated with a team effort, because it really takes all professionals in the health arena to work well together, because patients require everyone's attention, not just chiropractors. So because I found a mentor early on, I was ultimately enabled to build a very unique practice. It's the first of its kind. And I was in the midst of doing that, I was told by many, many people that what I was trying to do was strange, unrealistic, crazy, maybe impossible. But you know, when I hear that, all I think is, good, I'm gonna try even harder to do that, because that tells you something. So one way to guarantee success, not to only find a mentor, but to also not to try to reinvent the wheel. Our successors, chiropractors, have blazed a very difficult trail that is very difficult to uphold and further it. So I am up to the task to keep that trail blazed, to further new paths, and to innovate new ideas on a regular basis. And I need your help. This will be your focus, I hope, in the next couple coming weeks. Reach out to as many individuals as possible. They don't have to be chiropractors. They can be business people. They can be attorneys. They can be medical doctors, your parents, anyone. Surround yourself with smarter people. That's all I did. If you surround yourself with smarter people, hopefully, in the long run, some of that will rub off on you. I'm still working on that, so reach out to me in a couple years, maybe. So, you know, this is all important because mentors help you fast-track your progress, help you fast-track success. And it's so important in today's age, just because the video we watched, there are so many people on the rise using legal and illegal drugs to help themselves. The cost of healthcare is not going down, it's only going up. So our country needs great chiropractors now more than ever. And I truly feel that with Logan's curriculum and great mentorship, you will be outstanding physicians for this country. Leaders, not followers. And I have a feeling that everyone's up for that challenge. I'll leave you with one more thought that a mentor of mine told me when I was actually at trimester one, and he said, Drew, your innermost dominant thoughts will inevitably become your outermost tangible reality. Your innermost dominant thought will become your outermost tangible reality. I thought, well, that was deep. Okay. So I thought about it, and like it just dawned on me like last night. No, I'm kidding. So what it really means is think with a positive attitude, not with a negative one. Think like a leader, not a follower. Then allow yourself to demonstrate innovation and success. Develop a team, stick to the plan, don't reinvent the wheel. I wish all of you the best of luck and success. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Durow. Our final speaker is a current trimester 7 student and Logan's Women's Leadership Council president, among other leadership roles. Please welcome Abby Smith to offer a few words of encouragement.
Hi, my name is Abby Smith, thank you. I am a current trimester 7 student, as was already said, a member of Logan Student Government. I met most of you already, and also the president of Women's Leadership Council. I would like to congratulate you on beginning this next step of your journey. And I'm not gonna lie to you, it is quite a journey to embark on, and I am very impressed by all of you. I would like to remind you that it's also an amazing journey, though. I mean, I do not regret it at all, and I would definitely tell everybody to come here. You will learn and hone this amazing craft that is chiropractic. You'll meet amazing mentors, all these people over here and on this stage currently. They are here for you every step of the way, and they want you to become the best chiropractor that you can be. You will also meet amazing friends that will experience the tough times with you, but they will also experience the amazing times. And sooner, much sooner than you realize, you'll be walking across this stage again to graduate. This truly is a wonderful experience. And I would like to offer the following pieces of advice to you. My first piece of advice is to take a moment and think about why you're here, why you're at Logan University, and why you're becoming a chiropractor. Knowing why you're here is going to be one of your main driving forces through this schooling experience. When you have exams and quizzes and practicals and everything else that goes on with this school, knowing your why will help re-energize and re-excite you. My second piece of advice is to find your tribe and keep them close. I cannot imagine what the past 6 trimesters would have been like without my friends and family that I've created here. Some of them are students, and some of them are most definitely faculty. The family that you create will help bolster and encourage you during the tough times, will help you remember to laugh at least once a day, sometimes out of exhaustion, but sometimes just because things are funny. And they will also assist you in becoming the best chiropractor that you can be. And if you're anything like me, your family will see you at your most stressed, which sometimes includes crying in public, out of exhaustion and stress, but they still love you and they stick by your side through all of it. And the family that you create here will be for life. My third and final piece of advice is remember to do the things that make you happy. In order to provide the best care to your future patients, you need to be the best version and the healthiest version of you that you can be. And sometimes this means taking a little break from the stress of school and doing something for your soul that makes you happy. And now I would like to leave you with some information and statistics that I heard at this year's Logan Spring Symposium. A 2016 census reported that there are 70,000 licensed doctors of chiropractic in the United States of America. And each day, they are treating over 27 million Americans. Another report states that 74% of the American population, desires a natural approach to healthcare. And of the 1 out of 3 Americans that report that they have used natural healthcare techniques before, 84% say they would use them again. And lastly, the American Holistic Medical Association defines holistic medicine as the art and science of healing that addresses the care of the whole person, body, mind, and spirit. I feel confident in saying that this is pretty close to how every single person on this campus will define chiropractic if you were to ask them. And as that video expressed, we need the medical doctors, we need the EMTs, all of those people, but in the end, we are the people that's going to put them back together and heal the whole body, mind, and spirit. And I will leave you by saying congratulations again on choosing the profession that the American population wants, the profession that heals the whole person, body, mind, and spirit, and in my opinion, the best profession out there. Congratulations and welcome. And thank you.
Thank you, Abby. Well, that concludes our speakers for the evening. Ushers, would you please prepare the students for the presentation of the coats? Would Dr. Jason Goodman, Director of Clinical Experience, and Dr. Christina Petrocco-Napoli, Director of Assessment and Accreditation, join us to present the white coats, along with Dr. DeBono and Dr. Robin Bozark, Associate Dean of the College of Chiropractic, congratulate each student. Future doctors, after receiving your coat and crossing the stage, you will return to your seat for the white coat oath. The first row has been left empty to allow for family and friends to take your photos. Names will be read in alphabetical order so that you can properly time your arrival. Alexander. Samantha Anderson. Desmond Ayete. Logan Bates. Jessica Burlesman. Adriana Bigger. Jason Branham. Hope Brock. Drew Callahan. Logan Cook. Davis. Jason Day. Thank you. Mahmoud Dre. William Emsch. Sydney Fenton. Elisa Green. Julian Hawkins. Michael Hawks. Alicia Hunter. Emily Jones. Michaela Kyle. Hyunjung Lee. Hayden Lowe. Brandon Madison. Anderson McLean. Renata Mendez. Hill Morgan. Amisha Murray. Ashley O'Brien. Ward Overton. Rachel Owens. Rachel Parsley. Tyler Parsons. Caleb Pearson. Justin Rindner. Alexander Ryan. Michaela Stant. Megan Still. Danielle Suh. Kaya Tansky. Mm-hmm. Christina Tharman. Courtney Thomas. Brian Troutman. Jillian Weiss. Charlay Williams. Dr. Vincent DeBono, would you please come to the podium to administer the White Coat Oath?
Can the incoming class please rise? You'll find a copy of the oath in your pocket. And then repeat after me. With this oath, I commit myself to the responsibilities of a chiropractic physician in training and to the obligations of the chiropractic profession. I will approach my chiropractic education with integrity and modesty, respecting the patients and educators from whom I shall learn. In pursuit of excellence, I dedicate myself to a lifetime of learning, teaching and advancing the art and science of chiropractic. I will faithfully serve the well-being of my patients and strive to be worthy of their trust through honest and compassionate and thoughtful communication. I will treat my patients with dignity, respect their individuality, safeguard their confidence, and serve as their advocate. I pledge to care for my health so I may effectively care for my patients. I will act within my abilities and recognize my limits. I will hold fast to the enthusiasm and idealism with which I take this pledge. This oath I make freely and upon my honor as a Logan University student.
This oath I make freely and upon my honor as a Logan University student.
You may be seated. Well, congratulations. I'd like to be the first to welcome you to the profession because you are part of the profession now. You're a student in training. So your conversations about what happened on Game of Thrones last night is the same significance as it was tonight as it was last night. But your conversations about when someone goes, hey, you're a chiropractor, I got this thing. Your conversation has completely changed. Even though you haven't sat in 1 hour of class, people now ask you and look at you differently and take your advice differently. So be careful. Remember, there's a reason this is 3.5 years long. It takes a while. So you have a whole added responsibility that's coming with this white coat tonight. You're in a different world now. So be careful. People will look at you differently. Be careful of your Facebook posts. Be careful of whatever Facebook's for old people, I know. Whatever, the Insta something, that stuff. Be careful. Because your future patients will look at that. And remember, social media is permanent. And no matter how fast you delete something, someone screenshotted it. And typically, we end up with it. So be careful. That's the biggest mistake I see with incoming classes. But on a word of encouragement, you're going into a wonderful profession. I have never been happier. I've been a chiropractor for 30 years. I've never been happier. And you are at the best institution to learn this art. We welcome you. We can't wait to get started with you. I'm going to bring Dr. Bandachinsky up now to close the ceremony.
Again, congratulations to the entering class of the summer 2019. We really look forward to working with you. Immediately following the ceremony, we'd like to get a photo of the class. Remain in the Walters Auditorium, and we ask that you return to the stage at the conclusion of this program. Guests, please join us in the lobby for a reception in honor of our participants tonight. An event such as this does not occur without the hard work of numerous individuals. I'd like to thank the admissions, student affairs, and academic technology departments, as well as the Purser Center staff for their assistance in coordinating this event. Thank you for coming, and once again, congratulations to Logan's future doctors.